This is perhaps the most well-known musical ever. Hello, my friends. Welcome back to the channel. Of course, I'm talking about The Phantom of the Opera by Andrew Lloyd Webber. In this video, we're going to be reacting and analyzing The Phantom of the Opera song from The Phantom of the Opera musical.
I am your angel of music. Come to me, angel of music.
Sorry, I'm going to pause right there just before they sing. But is there a more epic opening to a song than that? I don't think there is. The fog, the smoke, the lights, the costumes. This is one of the greatest musicals of all time. There's no question about it.
In sleep he sang to me. In dreams he came. That voice which calls to me and speaks my name. I dream again, for now I find the Phantom of the Opera is there inside my mind.
Christine Daae is going to start us off, and it's a difficult role. She has to sing very, very high, which we'll hear in just a few minutes, and also pretty low for a soprano. You may be a soprano who can sing high and sing low, that's great, but in the context of a performance, what makes Christine particularly difficult is you need to warm up for that high E or whatever it is, but you can't warm up too much because you'll really lose your bottom range. What Sierra's doing here, which I think is really nice, is yes, she's singing in dee da dee da da, but there's a brightness to that sound. She's not going da 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 and really sinking low into her voice and getting that whispered sound. She's going for the clearer tone. It's brighter, and that's going to help her later on in the song.
Inside my mind.
So it's that mind. So if you're a singer and you're singing low and it's kind of low for your range, brighten up the vowels. It's going to be a lot easier.
Sing once again with me.
Love his voice. I absolutely love it. There aren't many voices that I truly gush over. Andrea Bocelli is one that I really gush over, but this, it's such a great musical theater sound. I mean, when I think about a musical theater sound, when I am singing musical theater myself and I'm trying to, you know, shape my vowels and different sounds, this is the voice I think of. Two things that are working really well right now, and it's also led him to have a very successful career. First one, there's a bit of nasal sound in there. Don't be scared of singing with a bit of nasal sound. It won't be too much. And a teacher or a colleague or someone will tell you if it's too much, like Squidward. We don't want that. But we want a little bit of that yeah, 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 yeah sound to get to the back of the hall. We need that ring and ping. Second thing is he is always singing with support. He takes a nice breath and he uses that airflow consistently to sound good. So not only does he sound good in the moment, but he's going to sound good 10 years down the road, 20, 30 years down the road. He's got a long career and he's had a great career because he supports.
Do it.
Those who have seen your face draw back in fear. I am the mask you wear.
It's me they hear.
Your spirit and your voice.
Okay, this is fantastic. They really mesh well together. Not only are they fantastic actors, they've got great chemistry, but vocally, it's a perfect match. When we look at choral music, if you sing in a choir, if you have sung in a choir, you talk about blend. Can you blend voices together so it sounds like one cohesive unit? Because if you have one singer in a choir that sticks out, it's going to sound really bad. You also have to consider blend when you're singing duets and trios, if you're singing with someone, because you want to sound not like one voice, but you don't want to clash. And one thing that can really clash, and it's really bad actually, is the vibrato rate. So some people have really slow vibrato, some have really fast vibrato. Ben Platt, for example, has very fast vibrato. They'll tell the story of tonight. So if one's vibrato is faster than the other, it's gonna clash, it's not gonna sound very good, but they're matched up nicely.
You always knew that man and mystery were both in you.
I just thought about something really cool that I want to talk about. And it's actually the makeup and the mask for the Phantom. So if you can see, maybe I can go back a little bit. I've gone back a few seconds. I'll zoom in on his face. We have the mask on, obviously. And underneath the mask, which we find out later in the show, it's all deformed and scarred and it's kind of nasty. And then he's got big lips, and then he's got the microphone on, and then he's got the hat and the costume. So I will tell you from experience, I haven't played the Phantom before, but from doing other shows, this is a restrictive costume. The costume itself, the movement might not be so great, but also the microphone placement, you got a mask on, you got makeup on, things are a little bit tighter than you're used to. So when you're in rehearsals, things are easy to do because you're not wearing any of this. When you do the shows, it can be restrictive. So what does he have to do to make sure that he sounds good? Well, the sound and the space, all of that good work is going to happen inside the mouth because he's got a lack of mobility in the face and in the lips. So he has to make sure that he's got space in the back of the mouth.
That man and mystery were both in you and in this labyrinth where night is blind.
They're fantastic performers, and the acting is so good. You can just see it in their eyes and their face that they truly are invested in what they're saying. And Christina's, you know, all these things are running through her mind. She doesn't know whether to, you know, be scared and hate him or, you know, to be excited at this opportunity. Another element, another factor of blending with another performer is the vowels that you choose. So not only is the vibrato have to be somewhat the same, but the vowels have to be the same too. The Phantom. Notice they're both going, ah, Phantom. If you go Phantom or Phantom or something in between, it's going to clash. So that's something in the rehearsal room that they've talked about.
The Phantom of the Opera is there.
You can hear, I sort of keep pausing, but you can hear how there are so many different elements going on at once to make it a cohesive and good performance. So we can watch this video and just simply enjoy it. That's fantastic. I want you to do that. But when you break it down, there's so many things to look at. So the vibratos have to match or else it's going to clash. The vowels have to match or else it's going to clash. Also, the tuning. If the tuning is off, if somebody's a little bit high, somebody's a little bit low, or if somebody's in tune and then someone's a little low, it's gonna be a mess. If you don't notice anything, if you don't notice weird tuning, that means it's probably good.
My angel of music!
okay, she did it. Well, I'm exhausted from simply watching her do that. Clearly, this is the most challenging part for Christine, I would say, in the entire musical. Anybody who's played Christine, I'm sure you'll agree with me. It builds and builds and builds, and finally, we get the high E at the very end. How does she do that? Support, support, support. She needs a lot of airflow to make those high notes happen without getting tired, but also she has to limit the amount of tightness and restrictiveness in the throat. If you start to get tight, if your larynx starts to creep up and up and up, it's gonna be an absolute disaster. You need a relaxed larynx, space in the back that we talked about earlier, and then just let that note go.
Seat of sweet music's throne, to this kingdom where all must pay homage to music, music. You have come here for one purpose and one alone. Since the moment I first heard you sing, I have needed you with me to serve me. For my music.
Oh, okay. I guess that's the end of the video. I love this part when the Phantom is playing the organ and singing at the same time, but just listen to how connected his voice is. And you may have heard the word connected before in singing. What does it really mean? It means you're connected to your body. You're taking a nice breath, you're supporting your sound, and it's not disconnected from all that support system that you have going on. Even when he flips to more of his head voice or to that breathier, quieter sound, it's still supported. It's still beautiful.
To music, music. You have come here for one purpose and one alone. Since the moment I first heard you sing, I have needed you with me to serve me.
This is how it's done. This is who you should be modeling yourself after. You should take notes, listen to these people because they're absolute professionals. You can hear just the diction, the attention to detail with every single word. This audience, whatever they paid for tickets, it's not enough. Oh, also, I'm gonna save you a bit of potential embarrassment down the line. If you don't already know this, The Phantom of the Opera is a musical. I can't tell you how many times I've said, oh yeah, like I study opera or I'm an opera singer or something like that. And they go, oh, my favorite opera is The Phantom of the Opera. No, it is a musical. It just has opera elements and the word opera is in the title. I can see how you can get that wrong, but just in case you don't know that, I wanna let you know, save you embarrassment down the line. That's it for today's video, my friends. If you wanna work with me, you can apply to my coaching program. The link is in the description below. Thousands of dollars worth of resources, ebooks, courses, group coaching, one-on-one lessons, all sorts of things. You get to work with me too, which would be a lot of fun. Love to work with you. Link in the description. Thank you very much. I'll see you in the next video.